No. By 2.5.
30 plus 28.5 is 58.5.
Also pull 58.5 about right here. By 1.5 feet.
I walked into a math lesson, folks.
Okay, now we can talk. Sorry. I was trying to keep it all in my head because I can't walk all the way to the top of the form and
I know.
It. Okay, so we're not cutting that line. We're not cutting that line. So we need to cut a piece of foam like this. Oh, I reversed it. That's okay. It needs to look more like that. So I need to make up that difference. That measurement is right. We need to come. This same angle needs to be like this. And then we'll cut to here. That's what needs to happen. So essentially, that piece should fit right there. And then if we cut this off, this would be. Ah, see? It's wrong. Oh, I know what I did. I know what I did. Hold. There it is. That's what it needs to look like. That's what it should look like. That looks more correct. Yes. So, essentially, this is gonna sit like that. That line goes all the way up to the top. Yes.
Hurrah!
That is what it will look like. TJ? Huh? Eyeballs?
That looks more correct.
Correct. Yeah.
You reversed it, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this goes like this. No, I scooted it down because I realized this has to be our total height. Yeah. That's our highest point. And then it will come all the way down. Nice. Which does mean we have to get a 4-foot piece of foam in there, which I think we're still going to be able to do over the top.
Yeah.
Good morning. We're cutting foam for our last few lifts. It's good. And then we'll start in on more rammed earth. Yeah. Let's do it. All right. That's a weird shape. Well, I guess we're all done.
It was ready to break.
Well, that's our roof pitch.
What?
If I didn't know any better, I'd say we almost knew what we're doing. So this should be. Yeah, 59.5,
58.5.
It's a smidge short. No, it's a smidge long. If it dropped down to that level, it'd be correct. So we can take a little bit off of this if we wanted to. 9.5 feet exactly. What I want to see. Gonna be a little tall. It's okay, I'd rather be a little tall than a little short. It'll be flush with the top of the concrete.
Yes.
Similar to that. I think we're ready to ram. Yeah? Holes have been drilled for rebar.
It's been vacuumed.
It's been vacuumed. The rammer's connected. I pulled the hose out of the pulley and ran it just over the top of the form. I think that's it. Yeah, I think we're good.
The vertical rebar is still where it needs to be.
Yeah, vertical rebar is still where it needs to be.
You already did the lengths on those. You need to tape the line.
Yeah. And then I think we're good. All right, so we got the first lift about to go in. It's just going to be more of the same. But we'll show you when we do the next form piece and put in that really unique piece of foam that you saw me cutting earlier. So, yep. They don't have to be huge. They can be the medium-sized ones. The rammer's starting to untwist a little.
Okay.
So I just got to tighten it.
How tall does the next little cap need to be? So 4 foot and then 18 inches, 24 inches?
A foot or?
We have an 18-inch form over here.
That'll work.
Give us 21 feet, 6 inches.
Yeah, that's more than enough.
Okay.
And then we're ready for foam, rebar, and form. Rebar first. I need 4 more long ones.
So Luke's going to cut some rebar, which is not fun.
Going to attempt to cut some rebar.
You got this.
That was the worst job we had.
You're doing terrific. You're doing terrific.
If it didn't just completely give way, it would be slightly better.
Right?
But it does.
Yeah, it just says...
Snap.
Snap.
How's it going up there, love? You're a long way up.
No, other than the wasps, like, they keep... And they're hitting me. They're not stinging me. They're just hitting me. It's like they don't... It's like they're telling me to clear out of their war zone.
Hey, man. Ain't cut a stinger. You don't belong.
You don't belong here.
All right, so they're doing rebar, and then they'll have to put in the foam. Is this the funny piece of foam?
Yep. It's the funny piece of foam and the last form board.
Yeah, what about the, because you said you've got 4 sticks of...
And that's all I'll need, yeah.
8
so
foot
if you
and then the 2
sticks. More use,
uh-huh.
We'll be done with rebar. No, what I want you to do is take that saw.
Yeah.
And about every 2 feet-ish, just make a cut. So if the foam is standing, make a cut down.
Okay.
So I can shove,
the rebar down?
Yeah, down.
Do you want a slight V or do you just want a cut?
I think a cut will be okay.
Okay.
Scrap bits. So I grabbed a nice white one.
And here comes Luke. Do you want to do the back chamfers before foam?
Hold on, I'm in a war right now.
Okay.
Yes, I want to do the back chamfers.
Are they up there?
Oh, they're up here.
No, the chamfers. Not the wasps.
Yes, the chamfers are up here. Yeah. You may need the longer wood to metal screws, Luke, for this side. For the other side, you'll probably be all right with the new ones.
Okay.
Yeah, just hook onto the screw. Yeah, and actually, if that's how we're going to do this, Luke, then you can do it once we reset the scaffolding to this side.
Cool.
Thank you. you want to go about
3 inches.
Three inches north, toward the existing wall.
Lakeside.
Lakeside. Ooh, I like that.
We have lakeside, orchard side, well side, and sawmill side.
Okay. Or just east, north, south, west.
Well, that works for you and me, but we have other people here.
Hey, I'm getting there. Are you?
Granted, we don't have a lake yet, but we will. Someday.
You have scaffolding. Be safe.
It is, like, 2 points of contact safe?
No. You know the song. 3 points of contact. 3 points of contact. 3 points of contact. 3 points of contact.
Got two and a half.
One down.
Didn't even get started. All right, ready?
Send it. Two screws down.
I didn't know we were playing Plinko.
No mercy here, Luke.
They're too short.
Well, yeah, I said you have to use the long ones on this side.
What? I thought it was on the other side.
No, I said you'll be fine on the other side.
Oh.
Did you bring the long ones up?
Well, yeah, at least you pre-drilled the hole.
At least that, yes. All right, take two.
Send it.
Next up is foot down, correct?
2 feet down is fine. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, 2 feet down is fine.
Okay.
Well, the fact that I can look straight down this does mean it's level. That's encouraging. That one you don't have to pull super, super tight, just tight enough.
Well, it just made contact with the metal.
Oh, got it.
Okay, that good?
That's probably fine.
Cool.
All right, go ahead and swing it around. Kendall, you can start the air compressor so I can do chambers.
Okay.
May have just made it much more difficult to get out of this. That's a problem for 5 minutes from now. That's fine. Ooh, it's a great time for the wind to pick up. Yeah. That's what I was kind of hoping would happen.
Yeah, is that what you were hoping would happen?
Sorry, thought that was obvious. I was being facetious.
This is something else that we did that has been super helpful for this wall. Oh, you.
All right. I think we're good. Let's eat lunch.
And finish a wall.
Finish this day up. Yeah, we've only got 3 lifts. And then we'll start doing our angle, and I have a feeling that's gonna go really fast, maybe 2 buckets. And then we can do concrete cap. So 5 buckets max, then concrete cap.
Cool.
Yes, sir.
This is the other thing that we decided to do yesterday that has been super helpful. We put lines exactly where the tires need to go in order to line up the bucket exactly where we want it at the top of the forms. So with my back tire, the center of it at that center line, and my front tire at the center of this line right there, that puts our bucket exactly between the center cross pieces when the chute is open. Game changer.
All right, we are done with lunch. We've got about 5 more buckets left to do, and then we'll need concrete. It'll either be 4 or 5 more buckets, maybe 6, but unlikely. If I'm kind of getting better at judging. I say that and then cut to me being wrong in about 2 hours. Anyway, so we've got a few more lifts to do. Then we're going to do concrete. But we got the foam in, we got the formwork in, and then, yeah, we should be able to finish this today, assuming everything goes well. So, yeah, here we go.
This is gonna be the last bucket of rammed earth, and then hopefully we'll do 2 bucket loads of concrete and be done. Mixing it up right now, and then we'll be done with these walls. And then these guys need to get rinsed, the snuffy and the trowels.
Okay, so we got 35 lifts plus 2 lifts of concrete. And the concrete cap went on actually really nice. The slope wasn't too bad. I was able to smooth it out. It's a little bit bumpy, but that's just because I'm bad at concrete. But yeah, it's something to see. I can't wait to show you guys when we do the reveal in a couple of days. So stay tuned. All right, I think that's it for today. Oh wait, if you feel that you like this content, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button, because I feel like that's what YouTubers are supposed to say. Is that what YouTubers are supposed to say? I'm not sure. Hit that. Go ahead and smash that like button. I don't know.
No.
Destroy the subscribe button? Get the bell on! I don't know how to YouTube. Sorry, folks. All right.
Join us for our adventure.
Yeah, join our adventure. Thanks for joining our adventure. We'll see you later.